فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
We were speaking about بعض الأحكام المهمة المتعلقة بالصيام. We were talking about some important matters that were connected to fasting. We spoke about two points, which was the definition of fasting linguistically and technically. We also spoke about the ruling of fasting in the month of Ramadan and why was it given that name, Ramadan. We're now going to go into the third point, inshallah ta'ala, which is when it was made obligatory. And وَمَا جَاءَ عَنِ التَّدَرُّجِ فِي ذَلِكَ. And also what has come regarding in the gradual stages that Ramadan went through. Ibn Muflih. Ibn Taymiyyah saw Ibn Muflih one time. And he said to him, you're not Ibn Muflih, you are Muflih. You are a Muflih. You're not Ibn Muflih, you are Muflih yourself. You're a successful person. He has a book called Al-Furu', which is a Hanbali madhhab book. In the third volume, page 6, he said, Sawm Ramadan fardun ijma'a. He said, Sawm Ramadan fardun ijma'an. He said, fasting in Ramadan, it is fard, it is obligatory, ijma'an, by way of consensus. وفرض في السنة الثانية من الهجرة إجماعا. And it was made obligatory. It was made obligatory the second year of the Hijriah. When the Prophet migrated to Medina, the second year, it was made obligatory إجماعا by consent. This is إجماع. So if that's the case, how many years did the Prophet fast? وصام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسع رمضانات إجماعا. So he fasted 9 Ramadan, and this is إجماع. So here we found out, and this strengthens what we were previously talking about, which is fasting is what it is obligatory, إجماع. There's no خلاف on that. And it's also إجماع that it was made obligatory on the second year, of the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it's also a ijma' then, the 9 years the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fasted. He only fasted 9 Ramadans. And Imam Nawawi said the same in his Majmu', the 6th volume, volume 6, page 250. He said, Sama Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he fasted Ramadan 9 sinin, 9 years the Prophet fasted Ramadan. لأنه فرض في شعبان في سنة الثانية من الهجرة. Because it was made obligatory in the month of شعبان, in the second year of the هجرية. وتوفي النبي, and the Prophet, he died في شهر ربيع الأول سنة 11 من الهجرة. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he died in ربيع الأول, when the year was the 11th of the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the first part we know now, which is when was fasting made obligatory? Yunus, when was Ramadan made obligatory?
The second year of hijrah.
Second year of hijrah. Who said that?
Ibn Muflih.
Ibn Muflih said. What did Shaykh Al-Sam Taymi say about Ibn Muflih?
He's Muflih.
He said, you're Muflih yourself. What's his book?
Al-Furu'.
What month did he say, what month was it that the Prophet ﷺ was made obligatory on him?
Sha'ban.
Who said that?
Imam Nawawi.
Where did he say that?
In his
Majmu'. What's his Majmu'? What sharh book is it?
Akhi Ibn Ahmed
Shirazi. I mentioned it yesterday. Kitab Majmu' is a sharh of which book?
Al-Umla?
It is a sharh of Abu Ishaq al-Shirazi. Abu Ishaq al-Shirazi's kitab Al-Muhadhab. It's a sharh of his kitab Al-Muhadhab. So now we've spoken about the tariq in which it was made obligatory. We're now going to move on to what? We're now going to move on to the next part of the heading, which is من جهة ما جاء من التدرج في فرض صيام رمضان. The gradual stages that fasting Ramadan has had, it went through. Because as we know, فإن فرضه لم يكن جملة واحدة. The fasting of Ramadan was not all at once. وإنما جاء على مراحل. Rather, it came in stages. حتى يعتاد الناس عليه, so the people can become used to it. كما جاء ذلك مبينا في بعض آيات وأحاديث الصيام. As it has come clear in some of the ayat of the Quran and some of the ahadith pertaining to fasting. ويمكن تقسيم هذه المراحل باختصار إلى ما يلي. The stages that fasting went through are the following. It went through four stages. It went through how many stages? Four stages. So we're going to tackle each stage one after the other. Four stages is the stages that fasting went through. Stage number one. Al-Marhalatul Ula, first stage. Marhalatul Ijabi Siyami Ashura. وَثَلَاثَةُ أَيَّامٍ مِنْ كُلِّ شَهْرٍ. The first stage was the stage where the fasting of Ashura was obligatory and 3 days of every month. 3 days of every month. Al-Imam al-Baghawi in his tafsir, the first volume, page 196. He said, كَانَ فِي ابْتِدَاءِ الْإِسْلَامِ. He said, at the beginning of Islam, it was صَوْمُ ثَلَاثَةِ أَيَّامٍ مِنْ كُلِّ شَهْرٍ. It was fasting 3 days of the month. وَصَوْمُ يَوْمُ عَاشُورَى وَاجِبًا. And the fasting of Ashura, that was obligatory. فَصَامُوا كَذَلِكَ سَبْعَةَ عَشَرَ شَهْرًا. The Prophet and the companions, they fasted 17 months. Of every month, 3 days they were fasting, 17 months. ثُمَّ نُسِخَ بِصَوْمِ رَمَضَانِ. And then it got abrogated, he said, with the fasting of Ramadan. انتهى كلامه. His statement is finished, Baghawi. And the evidence for that statement of Imam al-Baghawi, which is the hadith in which Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, on the authority of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, and also Ibn Abbas narrated it. Aisha said, كان يصوم عاشوراء يوما تصومه قريش في الجاهلية. Sorry, he said, قالت Aisha said, كان يوم عاشوراء يوما تصومه قريش في الجاهلية. She said that Ashura was a day that Quraysh used to fast it in the Jahiliyyah pre-Islamic time. وكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصومه, and the Prophet also used to fast it. فلما قدم المدينة, and the Prophet came to Medina, صامه, he fasted it. وأمر بصيامه, and the Prophet commanded the people to fast it. حتى إذا فرض رمضان كان هو الفريضة. Until Ramadan was made obligatory, that became the obligatory one. وَتَرَكَ يَوْمُ عَاشُورَى, and Ashura was left. فَمَنْ شَاءَ صَامَهُ وَمَنْ شَاءَ تَرَكَهُ. Whoever wanted can fast Ashura, and the one who wanted it can leave it. Because it became a voluntary act. As for the hadith of Ibn Abbas's one, because Aisha and Ibn Abbas both narrated it, Ibn Abbas's one says, إِنَّ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَمَّا قَدِمَ الْمَدِينَةِ. Ibn Abbas' one is slightly different in terms of its wording. It says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he came to Medina, وَجَدَ الْيَهُودَ يَصُومُونَ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he found the Jews were fasting the day of Ashura. فَقَالَ sallallahu alaihi wasallam لَهُمْ. The Prophet said to them, مَا هَذَا الْيَوْمِ الَّذِي تَصُومُونَ. What is it this day you guys are fasting? What is it you guys are fasting this day for? فَقَالُوا, they said, هَذَا يَوْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. He said, this is a great day. they said to the Prophet, this is a great day. When the Prophet came to Medina, he saw the Jews fasting and he asked them, why are you guys fasting for? And they said, هَذَا يَوْمٌ عَظِيمٌ, this is a big day. أَنْجَى اللَّهُ فِيهِ مُوسَى وَقَوْمَهُ, Allah saved Musa and his people. You see, وَغَرَّقَ فِرْعَوْنُ وَقَوْمَهُ, and Allah, he drowned Fir'aun and his people. فَصَامَهُ مُوسَى شُكْرًا, and Nabiullah Musa fasted in gratitude to Allah. فَنَحْنُ نَصُومُهُ, and because of that we are fasting. That's what the Jews said. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ, then the Prophet said, فَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ, we are more befitting and more closer to Nabiullah Musa from you guys. فَصَامَهُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ, so the Prophet fast, وَأَمَرَ بِصِيَامِهِ, and he commanded the people to fast. It was obligatory. Are you with me? Also, from the evidences that show this is the hadith narrated by Imam Abu Dawood, وَابْنُ أَبِي شَيْبَةٍ وَصَحَاحُ بْنُ خُزَيْمَةٍ, Ibn Khuzaymah authenticated it, وَغَيْرُهُ, and other than him authenticated this narration, which is from the noble tabi'i, من حديث التابعي الجليل, the noble tabi'i, من حديث التابعي الجليل, عبد الرحمن بن أبي ليلى, عبد الرحمن بن أبي ليلى. He mentions في ذكر أحوال فرض الصلاة والصيام قائلا, he mentions the situations of the fasting of the prayer, fasting in general, and the obligation of prayer. He spoke about it, and he said, حدثنا أصحابنا, he said, the companions of the Prophet told us, because another riwayah says أصحاب رسول الله, that the companions of the Messenger told us that أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لما قدم المدينة أمرهم بالصيام ثلاث أيام, that when they came to Medina, the Prophet commanded the companions to fast 3 days. ثم أنزل رمضان, and then the month of Ramadan came. وكانوا قوما لم يتعودوا الصيام, and they were a people who were not used to fasting. They weren't used to fasting like this. وكان الصيام عليهم شديدا, and the fasting was very hard on them. فكان من لم يصم أطعم مسكينا, so the one who didn't fast would provide for a poor, he would give a poor. فنزلت هذه الآية, then this ayah came down, فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم, anyone who has seen the month he should fast, obligatory. فكانت الرخصة للمريض والمسافر فأمروا بالصيام, so the rukhsa, which is the burden to be uplifted, was only specified for the sick and the one who was a traveler, and the rest were commanded to fast, meaning that that rukhsa was taken from them, which is they weren't used to fasting. So Ramadan was a choice in the beginning, and that's the second stage now. The second stage now, which is al-amru bi-siyami Ramadan, the ordering of fasting of Ramadan, but not in an obligatory manner. لا على سبيل الإجاب, they were told to fast Ramadan, but not in a forceful manner. وإنما على سبيل التخيير بينه وبين الإطعام, they were given the choice whether they wanted to fast or they wanted to provide for. And you just heard me narrate the hadith of Abd al-Rahman ibn Abi Layla. That was the evidence for it. Are you with me? And the scholars, they say this stage, which is the second stage, was an introduction to the third stage that's going to come, inshaAllah ta'ala. This was like a stage in which they were getting prepared for the third stage. Are you with me? So they can become used to fasting, and that they can exercise themselves onto it, and that they can, and it can be easy for يَسْهُلَ عَلَيْهِمْ قَبُولُهُ, so it can become easy for them when the third stage comes that they can accept it. Are you with me? And as you heard me, I mentioned the hadith of Ibn Abi Layla. Also the ayah in the Quran, it also mentions that as well, which is the ayah Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 184. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 184, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُطِيقُونَهُ فِدْيَةٌ طَعَامٌ مِسْكِينٌ فَمَنْ تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ وَأَنْ تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, which the ayah says, as Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said in the tafsir of this ayah, he said that الصحيح المقيم الذي يطيق الصيام كان مخيرا بين الصيام وبين الإطعام, that the one who was healthy, who was a resident, meaning he wasn't a traveler, who was able to fast, he had a choice if he wanted to fast or if he wanted to feed. He had a choice. It wasn't forced. إن شاء صام. If he wanted, he fasted. وإن شاء أفطر. And if he willed and wanted, he would not fast. But what he would do instead was وأطعم عن كل يوم مسكينا. But every day he would give a miskin food. فإن أطعم أكثر من مسكين عن كل يوم فهو خير. And if he chose to go by providing for more than one miskin a day, it was better for him. وإن صام فهو أفضل من الإطعام. And if he fasted, it would be better for him than anything else. And that view was a view mentioned by that there was a stage like this, that this stage existed, which is called the stage of what? الأمر بالصيام رمضان لا على سبيل الإيجابي ها وإنما على سبيل التخيير بينه وبين الإطعام. The one who said this is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Mujahid ibn Jabr, Tawus ibn Kaysan, Maqatil ibn Hayyan, وغيرهم من السلف. And other than them, from the Aimat al-Salaf. Then the third stage now, which is called Al-Marhala al-Thalitha. The third stage. The third stage was what? Al-Amru bi-Siyami Ramadan. The fasting of Ramadan. Ala sabili al-Ijabi, in a forceful manner, wal-Azima. Biduni takhiri, no choice. You have no choice. And this is the stage which the matter finally stood on. Meaning this became, it became what is known as al-marhala التي استقر عليها حكم الصيام. It is the stage which the fasting of Ramadan finally it stood on this one. Meaning فأصبح واجبا حتما على كل من شهده صحيحا مقيما. It became obligatory and it became mandatory on every single person who sees this month, who is healthy and who is a resident. The only one who was given an excuse and the burden was uplifted from him was وَإِنَّمَا رُخِصَ فِيهِ لِلْمَرِيضِ وَالْمُسَافِرِ أَنْ يَفْطِرَا وَيَقْضِيَانِهِ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ آخَرَ فَنُسِخَتْ آيَةُ التَّخِيرِ. And the only ones who were, this ruling was lifted from was the one who was sick, the traveler. They were both permitted to break their fasts, and that they bring that fasting back on another time. And the ayah that we read before, which is وَعَلَى الَّذِينَ يُطِيقُونَهُ فِدْيَةٌ طَعَامُ مِسْكِينٍ فَمَنْ تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ وَأَنْ تَصُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, which is ayah 184. That ayah نُسِخَتْ, it was abrogated, which is called ayah التخير, the ayah of choice. It was abrogated. With which ayah? Which ayah was it abrogated on? بِالْآيَةِ الَّتِي بَعْدَهَا, the ayah after it. Which is the statement of Allah, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ, the one who sees the month should fast. وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ, the one who is sick and the one who is a traveler, they have to bring it back other days. They have to bring it back on other days. That was the stage in which the fasting became what? Obligatory. The fourth stage, which is eating في تحليل الأكل والشرب والجماع مطلقا في ليل الصيام ونسق التحريم ذلك إذا نام الصائم ليلا. The fourth stage was what? The permissibility of eating and drinking. Having intimate relationship unrestrictedly at night time. And it was abrogated, the verses or the evidences that prohibited that if a person goes to sleep at night, are you with me? If he goes to sleep, he would what? If he goes to sleep, there was a ruling that if he went to sleep at night time, if he woke up, that's it. He has to carry on the fasting. You see, that was lifted. And this is called, this stage is one of the stages that completed the third stage. It was a completing of the third stage, the things that were added onto it. It was added onto it. Because the fasting of the Christians previous in fasting, and also at the beginning of Islam was what? أَنَّهُ إِذَا نَامَ أَحَدُهُمْ, that if one person went to sleep laylan at night time, لَمْ يَحِلَّ لَهُ, it is not permissible for him أَنْ يَطْعَمَ أَوْ يَشْرَبْ, it's not permissible for him to drink or eat, or even to have intimacy until morning or evening from that same day. And this became hard on the Muslims, became very hard on them. فَنُسِخَ ذَلِكَ بِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى, and this ayah abrogated the ruling. أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ الرَّفَثُ إِلَى نِسَائِكُمْ هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُنَّ عَلِمَ اللَّهُ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَخْتَانُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَعَفَى عَنْكُمْ فَالْآنَ بَاشِرُوهُنَّ وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ ثُمَّ أَتِمُّوا الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ. This ayah, which is ayah 187, abrogated it. And this is was what? فَنُسِقَ هَذَا الْحُكُمْ, that ruling previously that was there was abrogated. وَخُفِّفَ عَنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ, and ease was given to this ummah. And what were they allowed? And this distinct, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gave them a مِمَّا يَمْتَازُ بِهِ صِيَامُهُمْ عَنْ صِيَامِ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. We were given a different treatment from the previous nations, the people of the books. Huh? And we were ordered to come with what? Suhoor before Fajr. And that was made a sign, an alama, a sign to distinguish between our fasting and the fasting of who? The people of the scripture. And the evidence for that is the hadith narrated by Imam Muslim on the authority of Amr ibn al-As. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Prophet said, فَصْلُ مَا بَيْنَ الصِّيَامِنَا وَصِيَامِ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ, the difference and the fasila between our fasting and the fasting of the people of the scripture is the eating of the suhoor. And one of the evidence, or the long hadith of Ibn Abi Layla, the hadith is very long, we only mentioned some of it, in it is that Ibn Abi Layla mentions that the Sahabi told him, وَكَانَ الرَّجُلُ إِذَا أَفْطَرَ, if a man broke his iftar, iftar time came and he broke his iftar, فَنَامَ, and he went to sleep, قَبْلَ أَن يَأْكُلَ, before he could actually eat, he wasn't allowed to eat until the next day. And so what happened? Umar radiallahu anhu came one day and he wanted his wife. And then she looked at him and she said, إِنِّي قَدِّمْتُ, I slept. Are you with me? But Umar radiallahu anhu still had intimacy with her. فَجَاءَ رَجُّلُ مِنَ الْأَنصَارِ فَأَرَادَ الْطَعَامِ. Another time, a Ansari man wanted food. The wife went to get him the food, but she said, فَإِنِّي نُس... she said to him, فَقَالُوا نَحْنُ نُسَخِّنُ لَكَ شَيْئًا. She said, I will warm it up for you. فَنَامَ, he went to sleep. And then when he went to sleep, he wasn't allowed to eat. فَلَمَّا أَصْبَحُ, when they woke up in the morning, this ayah was sent down. أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ الرَّفَثُ إِلَى نِسَائِكُمْ هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُنَّ عَلِمَ اللَّهُ أَنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ تَخْتَانُونَ أَنفُسَكُمْ فَتَابَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَعَفَى عَنْكُمْ فَالْآنَ بَاشِرُوهُنَّ وَابْتَغُوا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ ثُمَّ أَتِمُّوا الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ. That ayah came down. So this is what's takhfif, to make the matter what? To make the matter easy for the believers. That was the final stage. And those were the four stages in which the fasting went through. Those were the four stages in which it went through. Now we're going to go into the fourth, last one, the fourth point, inshallah ta'ala, regarding the important rulings connected to fasting, which is the last one, which is Al-Hikmatu min Shar'iyyati Siyami. The wisdom. The wisdom in the legislation of fasting. So Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he said in his Kitab al-Qayyim, Majalis Shahri Ramadan, page 64. He says, Inna Allah subhanahu lahu al-hikmu al-ta'am. Inna Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He has al-hikmu al-ta'am. Allah has complete wisdom. فما خلقه له حكم التام فيما خلقه وفيما شرعه. In that which he has created and in that which he has legislated. Allah has complete wisdom in it. فهو الحكيم في خلقه وفي شرعه. Allah is wise in his legislation. And Allah تبارك وتعالى is wise in his creation. فما من عبادة شرعها الله. There's no type of worship which Allah has legislated for His creation, except there is a high wisdom in it. إلا لحكمة بالغة, a high wisdom in it. علمها من علمها وجهلها من جهلها. The one who knows it, and the one who's ignorant is ignorant about it. وليس جهلنا, and our ignorance بحكمة شيء, our ignorance of a wisdom in a matter من العبادات دليلا على أنه لا حكمة لها, is not an evidence that there's no wisdom in it. Rather, بل هو دليل, rather it is a evidence على عجزنا وقصورنا عن إدراك حكمة الله تعالى. Rather, it's an evidence that we are weak and that we fall short in comprehending the wisdoms of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لقوله تعالى, based on the statement of Allah, وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا. You've only been given very little knowledge. But the knowledge that you have been given is nothing except little. وَقَدْ شَرَعَ اللَّهُ الْعِبَادَاتَ وَنَوَّعَهَا. Allah, He has legislated types of worships. And He has differed between it. Why? ابْتِلَاءً وَامْتِحَانًا لِلْعِبَادِ. So He can test you and try you. لِيَتَمَحَّصَ الْقُبُولَ وَالْرِضَى. وَلِيُمَحِّصَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. The reason is because to purify the acceptance and the pleasement, and to identify and to clarify those who are true believers, to get them out from those who are claiming. فَإِنَّ مِنَ النَّاسِ, because from amongst the people are those which who are what? مَنْ قَدْ يَرْضَى بِنَوْعٍ مِنَ الْعِبَادَةِ. There are those people who will be pleased with a type of ibadah, ويلتزم به, and he will come with it. ويسقط نوعا آخر ويفرط فيه. But he becomes angry with another type of ibadah and he becomes short in that one. وإذا تأملنا عبادات الإسلام الكبرى, if we look at and we observe the great ibadat that are in Islam, like الصلاة, الزكاة, الصوم, الحج, الجهاد, if we look at them, وجدنا, we will find أن منها ما هو بدني محض كالصلاة. We will find from amongst them are those which are body and physical based ibadah, like the prayer. وَمِنْهَا مَا هُوَ بَدَنِيٌّ, and there are those which are physical, and also is wealth based, like hajj and jihad. وَمِنْهَا مَا هُوَ مَالِيٌّ مَحْضٌ, and from amongst them are those which are wealth only. في بذل للمال المحبوب إلى النفس, to give out the money that is most beloved to you. You see, كالزكاة, that is zakat. ومنها, and from amongst them is ما يكون فيه كف لنفس عن محبوباتها وشهواتها, and there are those which are restraining the nafs from the things that it loves and the things that it desires, like fasting. فإذا قام العبد بهذه العبادات المتنوعة, and if the person he comes with these different types of عبادات وأكملها, and he completes it على الوجه المطلوب, in the way he should, كان ذلك دليلا على كمال عبوديته. This is an evidence for his complete servitude. وانقياده له, and that he surrenders to Allah تبارك وتعالى. ومحبته لربه, and his love for his Lord. وتعظيمه له, and that he honors Allah and his. إذا تبين ذلك, if all of that which I have said has become clear. فإن للصيام حكما كثيرة, Fasting has a lot of wisdom. فَمِنْهَا From them are, number one. أَنَّهُ عِبَادَةٌ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى That it's a ibadah for Allah. The first wisdom is that it's a ibadah for Allah تبارك وتعالى. يَتَقَرَّبُ الْعَبْدُ فِيهَا إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ بِتَرْكِ مَحْبُوبَاتِهِ وَمُشْتَهِيَاتِهِ In which the person gets close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by leaving the things he loves and the things that he desires. Number two, أَنَّهُ سَبَبُ لِلْتَقْوَىٰ It's a means to attain taqwa. كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى فِي خِتَامِ آيَةِ الصِّيَامِ As Allah said at the ending of the ayah of fasting, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ فَإِنَّ الصَّائِمَ مَأْمُورٌ بِفِعْلِ الطَّاعَاتِ وَاجْتِنَابِ الْمَعَاصِي Because the one who is fasting, he is commanded to come with the act of obedience and to abstain from sins. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم as the Prophet said, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعَ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ Anyone who does not leave false testimony وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ and implementing it وَالْجَهْلَ and ignorance in it فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَّةٌ Allah has no desire. فِي أَيَّدَ عَطَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ Allah doesn't have no desires that you leave food and water drinks for him. Meaning, if you're committing sins, then why Allah doesn't want you to just leave water and food? That's not just the only concept of fasting, which is to leave food and drinking. وَإِذَا كَانَ الصَّائِمُ مُتَلَبِّسًا بِالصِّيَامِ فَإِنَّهُ كُلَّمَا هَمَّ بِمَعْصِيَةٍ تَذَكَّرَ أَنَّهُ صَائِمٌ فَامْتَلَعَ بِهَا Because if the person is indulged into fasting, every time he desires to commit a sin, he remembers that he is fasting and he abstains from it. Number three, from the third wisdom is, ومن حكم الصيام from the wisdom of fasting is, أن القلب يتخلى للفكر والذكر That the heart will become empty. For what? To remember Allah, you see, and to think about Allah تبارك وتعالى. لِأَنَّ تَنَاوُلُ الشَّهَوَاتِ Because taking in your desires يَسْتَوْجِبُ الْغَفْلَةِ It necessitates heedlessness. وَرُبَّمَا يُقَسِّ الْقَلْبَ And rather it may even taint your heart. وَيَعْمِي عَنِ الْحَقِّ And it blinds a person from the truth. وَلِذَا فَقَدْ أَرْشَدَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ And because of that, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم guided إِلَى التَّخْفِيفِ مِنَ الطَّعَامِ وَالشَّرَابِ That the person, he lessens on drinking and food by saying to them, مَا مَلَأَ ابْنُ آدَمِ وِعَاءً شَرًّا مِّن بَطْنٍ That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the children of Adam does not fill a vessel more evil than his stomach. أخرجه النسائي في الكبرى وابن ماجة وأحمد وصححه الترمذي وابن حبان والحاكم ووافقه الذهبي Number four. ومن حكم الصيام أيضا From the wisdoms of fasting is أن الغني يعرف به قدر نعمة الله تعالى عليه بالغني From the wisdom is that the rich will know the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in which He has placed upon the rich. حَيْثُ أَنْعَامَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالطَّعَامِ وَالشَّرَابِ وَالنِّكَاحِ That Allah has blessed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has blessed the rich with food, water, and nikah, marriage and intimacy. وَقَدْ حُرِمَهَا كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ الْخَلْقِ And many have been prohibited from this. فَيَحْمَدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى هَذِهِ النِّعْمَةِ وَيَشْكُرُهُ He will praise Allah on this blessing and he will show gratitude. وَيَذْكُرُ بِذَلِكَ أَخَاهُ الْفَقِيرِ And he will remember his poor brother. الَّذِي رُبَّمَا يَبِيتُ طَاوِيًا جَائِعًا He will remember his poor brother who would spend nights hungry and فَيَجُودُ عَلَيْهِ بِالصَّدَقَةِ and he would be generous to him by giving him charity. وَلِذَٰلِكَ Because of that, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَجْوَدُ النَّاسِ The Prophet used to be the most generous person. وَكَانَ أَجْوَدُ مَا يَكُونُ فِي رَمَضَانِ and he would be most be generous. He would most be generous in the month of Ramadan. Number five, ومن حكم الصيام, from the wisdoms of fasting is التمرن على ضبط النفس والسيطرة عليها. That the person, he becomes to restrain the soul and to govern it. والقوة على الإمساك بزمامها, and to hold on its, the front of its, of his affairs. حتى يتمكن من التحكم فيها, until he becomes fully controlled over it. وقيادها, and to divert it and to take it إلى ما فيه خيرها وسعادتها, in that which good lies. Fasting gives that to you. ضبط النفس, to restrain the nafs, to govern it, to have strength which you control it, until you can reach a point where you can take the nafs to whatever is good for it, and wherever it will find prosperity. Number six. ومن حكم الصيام, from the wisdoms of fasting is what? كسر النفس. It is to break the soul. والحد من كبريائها, to get rid of arrogance from it. حتى تخضع للحق, until it humbles itself to the truth. وتلين للخلق, and it shows kindness towards the creation. Because فإن الشبع والريء, فإن الشبع والريء, a full stomach and a thirst which is quenched, ومباشرة النساء, and having intimacy with the women, يحمل كل منها على الأشر والبطر والعلو والتكبر على الخلق وعلى الحق. All of that, having full stomach, eating, drinking, intimacy, all of that will take the person to what? Arrogance. Thinking high of himself. Conceit. You see, over the creation. And also from the truth. والمعصوم من عصمه الله تعالى, infallible is the one who Allah تبارك وتعالى makes infallible. Number seven. ومن حكم الصيام, from the wisdoms of fasting is أن مجاري الدم تضيق بسبب الجوع والعطش. The veins in which the blood flows, it tightens due to the hunger and the thirst. And when it does, shaitan is inside there. There's the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَجْرِي مِنْ إِبْنِ آدَمَ مَجْرَى الدَّمِ. That shaitan flows in the person, shaitan flows in the person where the veins, shaitan flows in the person where the blood flows. That hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. So fasting, the Sheikh said, it gets rid of the whispers of shaitan, wasawisu shaitan. And it also breaks the desires and anger. The desires and the anger. And that is why the Prophet ﷺ said, the Sheikh said, يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج. فإن أغض للبصر وأحسن للفرج ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم فإن له وجاء. O youngsters and youth, any one of you who is able to get married, he should get married. The scholars, they differ on what the word الباءة, what does it mean? There's أقوال, and this is not موطع البسط, the place where we deal with it. But the Prophet said, فليتزوج, let him get married. Why? فإن أغض للبصر, basar, getting married, is it makes a person lower their gaze. وأحسن الفرج, and it's good for your private part. ومن لم يستطع, anyone who is not able, فعليه بالصوم, fasting is on him. فإنه له وجاء, fasting is a وجاء for him. وجاء, it means, وجاء is what the Arabs used to do to their riding beast. When they want the riding beast not to have no children, and they want to destroy his desires because they just want him to work and they don't want him to have no children, because the camel, what it does is, there's a once in a year where it gets, it wants a woman, you see, and it starts to bring white stuff out of his mouth. You see, and it causes a lot of problem. It doesn't listen, it beats, it gets angry, it destroys everything. So what they do is they take that vein out. هذا وجاء. Or they may even destroy his the nuts and the bulls of the camel. They may even destroy it. So it won't have no desires. And the eighth one, which is the last one, the Sheikh said, وَمِنْ حِكَمِ الصِّيَامِ مَا يَتَرَتَّبُ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْفَوَائِدِ الصَّحِيَّةِ الَّتِي تَحْصُلُ بِتَقْلِيلِ الطَّعَامِ. From the wisdom is the benefits that come from the health benefits, sorry, that come from by eating less food. وَإِرَاحَةُ جِهَازِ الْحَضْمِ لِمُدَّةٍ مُعَيَّنَةٍ وَتَرْصُبُ بَعْضَ رُطُبَاتٍ وَفَضَالَاتٍ الضَّارَّةُ بِالْجِسْمِ وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. The health benefits that come by eating less food, in which the person, his physical internals, they are what? They are in good shape. And the Shaykh stopped there بإذن الله الكريم. And we'll stop there for today's lesson. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.